Hi friends, welcome all of you back to my YouTube channel. This is Virtual Teacher. I'm Pawan. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to install any application and game into Weepon Gaga application without downloading them once again from the Play Store. So let's start our video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification net, and join with me. Okay friends, first of all you need to install this 64-bit checker application on your phone. You can download this application from the given link in the description of this video. Then you can simply open this application and identify the bit version of your mobile. In here you can see I have a 64-bit OS, so I can go for 64-bit version of Weepon Gaga application. And also if you have a 32-bit version phone, definitely you need to install the 32-bit version of Weepon Gaga application. And also if you installed a 32-bit version of Weepon Gaga application on a 64-bit phone, then you can't add games and applications into that 32-bit version of Weepon Gaga application without downloading them once again from the Play Store. So in this method, I'm going to show you how to install and add applications without downloading them. So definitely you need to go for the Weepon Gaga application according to your device specifications. So then I can open this Weepon Gaga application and complete this small setup. So guys, when it came to here, you can see we have successfully installed and set up our everything on Weepon Gaga. So now you need to install two applications on your mobile. These are the applications that you need to install. First one is Sai application, and also other application is Explorer applications. Let's see continue our video after installing these two applications on our phone. Okay guys, now I have successfully installed both of these applications on my phone. Now I'm going to run this SAI applications. In here you can see there is an option called backup. Then you need to click on the select directory option and then click on internal file picker option. Now click on allow. In here you need to select a folder. I am using this folder as my backup locations. Then I need to identify the XAPK applications that I installed on my phone. In here I am going to install this prepare application, and that application not identified by this SAI application. If that application was identified by this application, that means that application has so many APK files in one application. If I click at this root browser application and click on this backup option, you can see there are so many APKs are inside of this one application. So I need to click on backup this all APKs. Then I need to open a Weepon Gaga application and install SAI application into Weepon Gaga. So, and also I need to add that backup APK files into here. So this is the root browser application backup files. Then I need to open this SAI application, and then you need to click on install and install system file picker and allow option. Then you will be able to come to this documents folder and find root browser. Then click on select. Now you can see our all applications are added to this installation process. Now you can install this APK without having any of error on inside into this Weepon Gaga application if it was a XAPK file. So let me see if it successfully installed or not. You can see it's installed. Let's try to run that one. Now you can see root browser is successfully installed and working. That's how we can install XAPK files into Weponggaga. Now if you have a normal application, you can normally add that application from file installation option. And now I'm going to install this FreeFire application. So you can see it's installing. It will be installed onto this application. Until then, I need to show how you can import the OBB files into Weponggaga application and how we can place that OBB and data folders. Okay friends, now you need to open this Explorer application. This application will help you to place your OBB and data folders into another location. Now you need to click on Allow File Manager to access your files. Then go to internal storage like this. In here you can find this Android folder and click on OBB. Now click on Continue and select use this folder option. Now click on Allow. Now that application will be able to find this OBB files. Now you need to click on this application and copy to clip, select copy to clipboard option. Now came to this ADM or other folder, like you all have the alarm folder. I'm selecting it, then click on paste. Now your file will be pasted into this alarm folder. And you can see our OBB file in this alarm folder. Now we can successfully add that file into Weponggaga. And other than this, you can go to this data folder and check whether if that folder has some data files of the game. Now you can see there is a data folder for Free Fire application. Now I can copy this one into another location like alarm folder, and I can add that both files into Weponggaga. In this case, Free Fire application don't need to add this data folder, but some applications and games are needed this data folder, so you need to add this data folder too. Now I can go to this Weponggaga application. Now click on file transfer option and click on import. Now click on this file option and go to root directory. When it came to here, you can see if I go to OBB folder, I can't see any file in this folder. But if I go to this alarm folder, now I can find the OBB file here. Because of we have successfully backed up OBB file into another location. Now click on import after selecting the folder. Then you need to wait until completing of this process. Okay guys, now you can see our folder is successfully added to this Weponggaga. Now I need to install another application for place this Weponggaga application. I am using Explorer once again. Now click on import. Let's see, wait until completing of this installation process. Now you can see it's installed successfully. Now we can open the Explorer application and paste these files into a current location. Open documents folder. In here you can find the OBB folder. Now click on copy to clipboard option. Come to OBB and click on this. Come to Android folder and click on OBB. Then you can paste that folder into here. So yeah, now you can see we have successfully added our OBB file. Now you can delete the file that we have added to the documents. Then go to home and click on your game. Now you can run your game without having any of errors. And other than this, if you really want to add GL settings for this game, you can find my previous tutorial that I added and successfully configured with GL settings. Okay guys, now you can see our game is successfully installed and is working. I'm not going to play this game. So thank you all for watching this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification and join with me.